The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Hi and hello to everyone. My intentions for all of you in this Holy Mass is may you be filled with the light and peace of God. Yan din po din kasi ang gustong ipahatid ng Gospel sa atin. If you want to know the meaning of holiness, is nothing else but choosing to be at the side of light and of God's peace. So if someone will ask you what is to be holy, is choosing to be at the side of light and of God's peace. And for today, may dalaw pong gustong ipati sa atin ang Panginoon. Una, damagit ko na, is always choose and to side and to become and live as children of light. Children of light. Always choose to stay in the light. Remain in the light. And be a light to others. This is a beautiful reminder to all that you have both the capacity and both you are destined to be a person of light. You have the capacity that even your life right now is filled with darkness and confusion. God gave you the grace to be in capacity to have the light, to be enlightened. That's why just in case if our life right now is we are consumed right now by worries, by sin, if we are consumed by destructive habits, kagabi, if I happen to read yung dalawang article sa newspaper sa Philippine Star, I hope you read that. May dalawa pong kalaban ngayon ang Pilipino. Maraming nalululong sa online sabong. It's becoming a destructive habit to many. Many families are broken by moneyless because of that destructive habit. And there are so many kinds of destructive habit. Kaya nga ang gusto ng Ebanghelyo ngayon, please, choose to be in the light, not in darkness. And sabi pa ni Jesus, just in case we are being consumed by fear, by anxiety, by feeling of worthlessness, yung pakiramdam mo na wala ng kwenta ang buhay mo, if you are consumed, may good news po ang Gospel ngayon sa ating lahat. Anong good news niya? First, sabi ni Jesus, do not be afraid. Because it's not yet too late. It's not yet too late. So this is a good to all of you. When you think it's already too late, God said, your situation can still be reversed. Mababaliktad pa yan. Kasi nga, si Jesus is the light who will help you turn around your situation. May room pa, may pag-asa pa. You can reverse the situation. To work not against you, but to work for you. Work on your favor. So may pag-asa. Kaya nga po, remember, that's the reason we call Jesus Savior, because dumating siya, pinadala siya, to intervene into our lives, to offer us forgiveness, to offer you new direction, to offer you new life. And this is what you call salvation. Kaya nga po, whatever your concerns right now or what you're going through, sabi ng Gospel, God knows them all. Do not hide any secrets from God. And do not be ashamed and embarrassed with the Lord. He will be ready to welcome you. Kasi ang kanyang dalangin lang para sa ating lahat is to be able to reverse our situation from darkness to light. From hopelessness to hope, from weakness to courage. After all, sabi sa Gospel, wala naman talagang gamit if we're going to hide from God or hide our weakness from God. That's what, if we hide our weakness from God, that's what you call pretending. We cannot really hide anything. So, before the Lord, tell everything what you need. Tell everything, your goal, your plans, and leave to Him the result. In short, put your heart to God. allow His truths, His teaching to rule and operate. He is the way. Yan po ang gustong ipaalala sa inyo. Yan ang pakilala sa atin ni Jesus. I am the way, the truth, and the life. Ask the Lord, Lord, dwell in me. I give myself all to you. And tell the Lord, Lord, I want to be united with you. I am saying this po kasi that's also the heart of the teaching of Saint Teresa of Avila, whom we celebrate today's feast. Para sa kanya, gusto yung man natin sa hindi, kailan natin dumaan talaga sa tatlong proseso na pagpapabanal. Ang first process na pagpapabanal ay what you call illumination. Papasok ka sa ilaw. Kaya nga, you don't have to be afraid. Parang flashlight. Pag inilawan mo, makikita mo talaga yung woundedness mo, kahinaan mo, weaknesses mo. But it's okay. What is important is you open yourself to the Lord because the Lord can really do something. Pangalawang process po, sabi ni Santa Teresa, na pagdadaanan natin ay yung detachment. Alam nyo, sa ayaw na gusto dumaan sa detachment, you know what's the reward? Destruction of the soul. So there's no other choice but after enlightenment to come to the Lord and ask, Lord, what can I detach myself from away? Anong pwede tanggalin sa akin para mas maging mayabong aking buhay? And ask the Lord for healing, for the grace of healing, healing of our thinking habits, na mabagong ating pananaw, our line of thinking, mabago yung ating emotional habits. Kaya nga po, pag sinabi yung pagpapabanal, is really a bloody process that sometimes God will use trials and suffering, kasi what is God after for is salvation of the soul. We may lose our body for a while, our material things, but if it's for the good of our soul, our salvation for eternity, the Lord will allow it. Yan po ang point ng gospel, kasi for the Lord, His priority is for us to be saved. Kaya nga, allow God, Lord, what do you want that I will change? What habits you would like me to be away from me? And last po, ang tugatog ng kabanalan, according to Santa Teresa, is to be united with the Lord. To be in unity with Jesus. And sana, ang invitation sa atin is to walk in this process. At pangalawa naman, na gustong ipadil po ng gospel sa atin, na gustong ipasabi po sa inyo ngayon, na you are worth more than sparrow. Sa Tagalog, mas mahalaga ka kesa sa mga ibon. Kasi po that's a message sa symbolic lang naman. Sabi po daw sa gospel, ang value ng limang ibon, a sparrow, is 2 small coins. Pag sabi ni Jesus na, you are worth more than a sparrow, ibig sabihin, you are valuable more than any other material things. Yung kahalagan mo bilang tao ay hindi maihambing sa halaga ng pera. Kaya do not allow, just in case you lose money, do not allow that it will consume you or destroy your soul. Kasi you are more than money and material things or more than any achievement. Ibig sabihin, your value as a person cannot be measured by any material or worldly things. So do not measure your happiness based on the money you have on your pocket right now. Because if you will do, you will always be desperate. Magandang paalala yan. Ulit sabi ni Jesus, do not be afraid. In other words, do not allow na mapuno ang buhay natin ng insecurity if we have less or lesser achievement. Or wag din po gawing dahilan ang ikakayabang dito natin just in case marami tayong pera. Ang mahalaga, gawing dahilan ng ilaw ng Diyos, maging motivation natin to keep going on, to keep hoping, to work hard for the family and for the goals we still have in life. Motivation. May the Spirit of God motivate you. His light motivate you. His peace. Kasi that is something permanent. In short, please always be at peace with yourself, because in all things and ways you are a child of God. Your value as a human being is indissoluble. Kaya nga para sa Panginoong Diyos, He likes that you will be saved. Everything about you will be saved. Body, mind, heart, and soul. Total of you will be saved by His grace. Basta ang mahalaga, choose to live in the light, stay and remain in the light, and be a light to others. Asa ka po iwasan, lalo na yung mga masasamang gawain na makakasira sa buhay ng iba. Bilang tao, meron tayong kalayaan. Sana we choose always to live under the state of grace, that is choosing to live under the state of light. God bless everyone. Let us pray to our Father in heaven with complete trust, so that free from all paralyzing fears, we may have the courage to build up His kingdom. For every prayer, your response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our church leaders may not be discouraged by the trials and challenges of renewal, but be more committed and zealous in bringing about change and conversion.